You may have seen cremation of your loved ones and may have questions like, what is the logic behind cremation? Is there any scientific reasons behind cremation? Why my loved ones should be burned? Is cremation environment friendly? Why to prefer cremation over burial? We will go through the answers of all these questions in this video. Philosophical reasons behind cremation. Human body is made of 5 elements: Bhumi, Agni, Varuna, Vayu and Akash, collectively called as Panch Mahabhuta or the 5 great elements in Hinduism. Whole procedure of Hindu cremation ceremonies are directed towards returning the body back to these natural elements. Burning of body includes fire element, smoke going upwards includes air and ether, ash getting mixed in soil includes earth element, soul going upward to sky include ether element, ash thrown in river or sea includes water element. Cremation liberates the soul from physical body. Death in Hinduism means only the end of physical body, not the end of life. Hindus believe that the body is a temporary container for an immortal soul in the mortal realm. On death, physical body dies, but the soul lives on and continues its journey of birth and death in another body. This cycle of birth and death repeats until the soul is liberated. After having inhabited the body for many years, soul becomes so much attached to the body that it may still want to remain in the physical body even after death. That's why women are kept away from ceremonial rites, as they are very emotionally attached, and seeing their emotional cry, soul may try to linger around the physical body. All these things stops the progress of the soul in its spiritual journey for salvation or reincarnation. And therefore, it is advised by sages to perform all rituals, including cremation, to detach the soul from its material body, as otherwise the soul will try to hover around the loved ones. Cremation ensures that there is no body left for the soul to exist, and hence it has no option other than moving on to the next stage. Dispersing the ashes in the river is the final act of liberating the soul from its mortal attachments. Before firing the pyre, elder son circumambulates the body 3 times. I have already explained the science behind circumambulation in another 10 minutes video, link of which you can find in the description of this video. Cremation protects you from dangerous diseases. Human being doesn't die always from old age. They may also die due to diseases spread by harmful viruses. When the body dies, it becomes toxic in nature and attracts harmful microorganisms, maggots, flesh-eating insects, etc. When we burn the body at 800 plus degrees Celsius, all these harmful microorganisms are killed, and hence cremation prevents the spread of dangerous diseases. When we bury the body, harmful body fluids and dangerous microorganism mixes with the water inside the oil. This harmful microorganism may enter your body via drinking of groundwater or via eating of vegetables or animals grown near to burial sites. This is why cremation is therefore considered as the safest and fastest way to dispose the body. Cremation is environment friendly. Cremation is environment friendly as for every death, relatives and close ones are asked to plant at least 3 trees on special festivals like Makar Sankranti, Vaisakhi, Basant Panchami, etc. so as to compensate for pollution and wood burning during cremation. In tropical countries like India, soil is wet and have more water content in them. Burial in such places damages the fertility of the soil, and such valuable earth spaces cannot be used for crop cultivations for decades and centuries. Moreover, burial also results in the spreading of diseases, as explained before. So burial should be preferred over cremation only in desert regions where there is no groundwater, no arable land, scarcity of wood to burn the pyre, decaying happens rapidly, dangerous microorganisms don't survive in hot weather. This is perhaps the reason why cremation is prohibited in Abrahamic religion like Islam, Judaism and Christianity, has this originated either in the desert region or close to the desert region. Burning in fire is the right way of disposing the body. In Hinduism, dead bodies of humans as well as animals are considered impure. Only fire is an element that is strong enough to destroy any kind of impurity, as all the other elements become impure on mixing with impure things. For example, water becomes impure and unhealthy if mixed with filth or garbage. Air and sky becomes impure and unhealthy when mixed with gases like nitrogen, carbon dioxide, etc. Earth is impure with microorganisms, garbage, etc. Only fire is pure and fit enough to destroy all impurities. That's the reason why fire holds a very important place in Hinduism, and apart from cremation, it is also used in other events like marriages, puja, agni pariksha, etc. to destroy the impurities all around us. On the other hand, burial is a very slow process of disintegrating the body back to the nature. Moreover, leaving the dead body to be consumed by animals and microorganisms is considered as a disrespect of the dead. So offering the body to the fire god is considered as an optimal way of performing the last rites. Why to throw ash in Ganga river? Ash when mixed in river is fit to be used in farm irrigation, as all the salty minerals are dispersed along the lengthy stream of river. Since bones constitute of phosphates, the ashes dispersed in the river increases the phosphate content of the water, which helps in better farm irrigation. This is why ancient sages advised throwing the ashes in river, especially Ganga, as it is considered the holiest of all rivers. Modern scientific research has proved that only river Ganga has more than 20 viruses that destroys all impurities and kill harmful microorganisms in the water. Only river Ganga has antimicrobial properties and self-purifying properties that is used in the treatment of diseases like tuberculosis, pneumonia, cholera, etc. Modern science has still been unable to answer on why oxygen level in Ganga is 25 times higher than any other river in the world. This scientific research has concluded that water of Ganga is holy, and this is perhaps the reason why river Ganga alone irrigates 2 million hectares of land, and the area around Ganga river is the most fertile in the world. Ancient sages knew the self-purifying properties of the river Ganga, and so they advised throwing the ashes in river Ganga to liberate the soul for its journey towards the heaven. Cremation avoids occult mischief. That is another reason to disperse ashes. Bones are often dug and used for occult practices, believed to recall and control the deceased and to gain superhuman powers. This occult practice is not possible in the case of cremation, as there are no bones and all ashes are dispersed in river. Cremation is easier and cheaper. Digging a grave is a laborious task and requires special implements for preserving the body. Cremation comparatively is easier, quicker and cheaper. Burning an adult human weighing 90 kilos leave behind just 2 kilos of bone residue, which can be easily dispersed in any water body. Conclusion: cremation is prescribed in the Vedic text and is followed not only by Hindus and other Indic faiths like Jainism, Sikhism and Buddhism, but also by Christians, Jews and indigenous religions. It should also be noted that many intellectuals like Albert Einstein, Robert Oppenheimer, John Kennedy, Rudyard Kipling, George Bernard Shaw, George Harrison, etc. opted for Vedic Hindu cremation rites without caring about excommunication by powerful churches. Recent figures show cremation are chosen by 35% in the US, 72% in the UK, 99.9% in Japan, 68% in Canada and 49% in China. And these figures are increasing steadily. I hope that you have understood the importance of cremation through this video, and it will assist you in performing the last rites of your loved ones in the right way. Thank you.
That's it in this video. Keep watching for more such videos. Thanks for watching. If you like the video, then please like, share and comment. And don't forget to subscribe my channel.